flyback converters are widely accepted because they operate on very high frequency, which reduces the size of magnetics drastically. These magnetics, which are generally flyback transformers made out of ferrite material, can provide galvanic isolation between high voltage line supply and low voltage output supply. Also, these supplies make use of a controller, due to which operation in constant current mode or constant voltage mode becomes very easy to implement. And with improved line and load regulation, when it is compared to conventional transformer-based power supplies, we get an upper hand. Also, the protection features like undervoltage lockout and short circuit protection can easily be achieved. This is the very first video of a series where we will develop an intuitive understanding about pulse width modulation, or PWM for short. These switching pulses will be used to fire a MOSFET. So let us understand it with the use of MATLAB simulations. Let us go to the Simulink model and let's add the required blocks for our simulation. In this blank Simulink model, we will add certain blocks from the Simulink library browser. We will require a sawtooth generator, in the Simulink library browser to add a particular block, you need to select it and press Ctrl plus I button. Apart from sawtooth generator, we will also require a constant block. A compare block or a relational operator block will compare the sawtooth generator output and the constant block output. A mux or a multiplexer with two inputs and a scope will also be required. This simulation will require a power GUI block as well. One needs the power GUI block to simulate any Simulink model containing specialized power system blocks. It allows you to choose the method to solve your circuit. Let us make the proper connection first. Basically, here we will compare sawtooth waveform to a constant DC waveform. We will understand the principle later in this video. We will have two separate axes in the scope so that we can visualize various waveforms properly. Mux or multiplexer will combine the constant and the sawtooth waveform and show it in one axis. Another axis in the scope will show the resulting PWM waveforms. Let us double click on the power GUI block and go to configure parameters option. Here we will select discrete simulation type and the solver type will be testing and will keep 10 raised to minus 6, that is 1 microsecond as our sample time. Now let us first input all the parameters for the sawtooth generator block. Double click to open it and for frequency we will input 20 kHz and we will use 0 degree phase lag. Hit enter to apply the settings. This will give us a sawtooth pulse of 20 kHz frequency and the time period of the sawtooth waveform will be 50 microseconds. Now for the constant block, let us input a constant value of 0.7. Let us change the simulation time as per our requirement and run the simulation. In the scope, we will have to change the axis properties for both the graphs for better visualization. Now as we can see, for a constant value of 0.7, the comparator block outputs a high pulse for the instant of time where the amplitude of the constant block is equal to or greater than the sawtooth pulse. Otherwise, the output of the comparator block is zero. Now let us investigate what happens if we reduce the value of the constant block to 0.4 from 0.7. Let us simulate again. We will set the excess properties again if we have to. As you can see, the amplitude of the signal has dropped. As a result, it is crossing the sawtooth at an earlier instant. Due to this, the time duration for which the constant signal was greater than or equal to the sawtooth signal has increased, which in turn has increased the duty cycle of the resultant output of the comparator. Hence, it can be said that the on time or off time can be changed as per our requirement by changing the amplitude of the constant block. And the frequency of the output pulses will be same as the frequency of the sawtooth waveforms. Hence, in order to change the frequency of the output signal, we will have to change the frequency of the sawtooth waveform. As we are manipulating the width of pulse here, the technique is known as pulse width modulation, or PWM for short. These pulses are then used to fire power electronic switches like BJTs, MOSFETs and IGBTs to control the output current and voltages, which we will see in the upcoming videos. Thanks for watching. Drop a like if you found this video helpful. Leave a comment if you have any query regarding the topic. And don't forget to subscribe and share this video with others.